Yo, what is going on, guys? It is your boy Seth here with a video here today. There's a brand new video bringing you guys an esports. I don't know what the video title is, but it's like esports, maybe grunge, dark theme. I don't have an idea, but maybe like a fun, clean esports. What is the title of this video? Whatever the title happens to be, basically you're gonna be learning a fun little esports kind of that I'll bring up right for you guys right now. Looks very, very clean, very fun, very kind of like grungy kind of style. And I haven't actually done a style like this before yet. So hope you guys do enjoy. Of course, leave a like if you guys did enjoy this video while you guys are watching it. Also comment down anything you wanna see me do personally. But with that being said, I love you guys. Let's start the video. And also for the record, all the assets and the fonts you'll see in this video will be in the description down below for you guys to download as per usual. Love you guys, enjoy the video, and that's it, enjoy. All right guys, so let me quickly show you guys how easy this is to actually do this header and how much fun it should be hopefully soon in a second here. So for this header, I am using a file new. Dimension size, this Twitter header for the record, is 3000 by 1000 height, 300 resolution at pixels, right? All that good stuff. That is the Twitter header dimensions if you guys were unaware. All right, I'm gonna close that down. So first things first is the background color. So the background color that I am using right in today's video is 0B0B0B is the hex code. Press OK, and if you guys want to quick fill that in, all you have to do is press Alt Alt on your keyboard and backspace, or you can just take a brush and fill it in just like so. However, with this background, that's not the only black we're going to be using in today's video. We're going to make a new layer really quick for ourselves. Nice little brush, right? Nice little soft brush, which is zero hardness. Nice little big size, and I'm going to change my foreground color from whatever color it was to a nice pure black. Now, this pure black color, I'm going to make myself just understand myself. I'm gonna zoom out really quick. So I'm gonna click over here, basically drag my mouse this way to give myself three little swipes, right? Just to make sure it's like, you know, nice, evenly coated. For the record, I am using a 60% opacity brush, so it's not at 100% opacity. If you guys wanna do the same exact thing, you guys can. So you click, you drag, oops, click, drag, click, drag, click, drag. Right, nice and simple, nice and clean. And it's honestly a super, super subtle color difference. So you might not even notice the color difference or whatever, change or whatever. However, you'll see in a second why I did that. Right, so right now, I'll show you guys right now, right? I'm gonna go ahead and just make myself a nice little, what is it called, like anagrams? What is it called when like you like take a big word, you make it smaller to like something that's obviously everyone would know? Don't remember. However, I'm using the font Stretch Sans for the record. Now, obviously this is an esports header. So whatever esports team you guys are doing this for, I would suggest you guys to like, if it's like for Team Liquid, you do TL. If it's for like Sentinels, you do SEN, right? Whatever, like shorten it up a little bit. Whatever team name you might have for your own esports team, just shorten it up a little bit. That way it's obviously easy to understand, because realistically, this doesn't really matter. This is just like a fun little added asset to the background. So with my little simple font here, also, for the record, I'll put the asset pack and the fonts down below in the description for you guys to actually download if you guys don't have them, right? Hold Alt, Shift, drag just like so, boom, drag just like so, boom, right? I'm gonna make one line. Now, realistically, I would even suggest you guys even do this, right? You can do like this, which is really cool and fun or whatever, but it's very stagnant. So I wanna give a little more movement. So I'm gonna hold Alt and drag it. I'm gonna make sure it's kind of like offset, like a checkerboard, just like this. Now, this for me is a little bit more easier or better in my opinion, right? So I just go like this, offset it again, like right around here, boom, and boom. And just like that, we have a nice style, a little almost like checkerboard like pattern with the word 100 or letters or numbers in this case, 100, right? Now for the color, it's not actually gonna be white. We're gonna change this color to the original color for the background color we had, which was 0B0B0B. Oops, 0B0B0B, right? Which is a nice little kind of like blackish tone. And just like this, you can see with the very simple usage of this little, of course, black, oops, it was black. Black brush, right? You can see the nice little subtle change. It's very, very, very subtle, very sexy in my opinion. It looks really, really good. Honestly, a really cool effect as well. If you want to use like a white, black background, I would highly suggest you doing this. Now, with that being said though, we're gonna go ahead and just drag in our logo, which is next, right? This is whatever esports team logo you guys are using. For me, it's gonna be 100 Thieves, right? Drag this in right around here. Now it is above everything. I'm gonna actually drag it below everything for a second, right? And if you guys wish to, I would pick it apart, right? You say, hey, whatever numbers or whatever your name, right, that you duplicate over and over and over again is over the letter or over the logo, excuse me, let me speak clearly, right? I'm gonna click on it, right? I'll say, I don't want it here. I'll drag this one, drag it below it. And I'll say, yo, maybe this one over here is a little bit weird. I'll drag it below it. That way it kind of gives a nice little interaction between like, you know, foreground, background, depth, where that kind of looks in front of here, behind here, behind here, in front of here, that kind of idea. So it looks kind of cool in my opinion, and I'm gonna run with it. So with that being said, now I'm gonna go ahead and just add in our character render. So the reason I'm adding my character render, because I'm just kind of doing it in the order that I would wish for you guys to do it as well. Now realistically, your character render can go right here, right? Let's drag this baby, make it a little more bigger. Okay, Now, of course, it's for esports teams, so I am using the player Nitro, which is main in Valorant, would be a Omen, right, in this case. So if you guys were to do an esports team or an esports player, right, you know, whatever game they're playing, League of Legends or whatever, have their main be the character render, so that way it kind of, you know, goes hand to hand, right? However, I'll have this like this. Don't worry about Nitro for a second right now, but have the character render in there for sure. Now, before you even do the character render as well, I want to make a new layer, right? I want to do this little information bar right here, this little thing right here, right? So for this, all I did was make a nice little rectangle marquee tool, selection, going down across the middle, just like so, right? And I quick filled this color in with the 0B0B0B hex code, right? Just like so, alt and backspace to quick fill it in a nice little foreground color in there, right? Just like this. And I also have the layer mask, which is very, very simple, very easy, which is basically a stroke at one, and of course, position on outside. And the color itself is basically a nice little gray 2F2F2F. And that way it's a nice little very seamless little bar here that goes across, looks really good, very simple, very easy, right? So now that we have all that stuff going in, we can actually drag in our little texture in here. So what I'll do, I'll drag in my texture, just like so, that's over here in the background. Again, this is in the description down below for you guys. I'll drag this and make sure this is like really cool, very obvious lines going through this. So you can type in like grunge textures or whatever you guys want to do, make you find your own little texture. So I have this in here. I'll go ahead and go over to normal and change to linear dodge add. Lower the opacity just a little bit to about maybe like 75% or so. And I can go into it. If you guys don't have a layer mask already, click right here, make a layer mask, take your brush, make sure your brush is down to like maybe like 20% opacity. If you use a black brush now, it'll erase very slowly though. So you have a very slow, a very soft touch, or a very soft, what is it called? Fill, like paint fill in your brush technically, right? Since it's at 20%, if you just click a few times, it's gonna take a long time for it to be fully away. So you can just go ahead and go around and say to yourself like, yo, it's a little bit messy here, a little messy there. Just make it a little fun, right? Now, granted though, we still work on this render for a second. You can see the little white lines around this render. It's a little ugly, right? So if you guys have the same exact thing, of course, I already layer masked it out. So I'm gonna quickly just convert it to a smart object, and I'll just go ahead and just rasterize it really quickly for you guys to understand, right? If it's a nice little simple PNG, right? I'm gonna hold control my keyboard, click on the thumbnail of the actual PNG, go to select, modify, contract. I'll say 3 to 2 pixels is really good. Press okay. Now all you have to do is use the rectangle marquee tool right here. That'll give you the option when you right click to layer via cut. And just like so, you delete the bottom layer. And now you get rid of all that weird white line stuff. It looks really ugly and weird. Now it looks super clean and nice. So now what I can do is I'm gonna go to my render, and I'm gonna go ahead and just make sure I click over here and use a gradient map, just like so. And on this gradient map, we wanna make sure it is clipping mask to the actual character render, just like so. And we wanna use a nice black and white. So on the left-hand side is pure black, right? On the right-hand side is pure white, just like so. Now, of course, this black and white is kind of cool. It's kind of like okay, but if you guys wanna make it even cooler, in my opinion, if you wanna click right here in the middle, just like so, around the middle, excuse me, more toward the left-hand side, right? Click on this, make this pure black as well, and then you get a nice super, super dope dark and like, it just feels more defined as a pure black, right? And I can go over here and move this to the left to make it a little more clear, right? Now this is what we want. That looks super, super dope. Press okay. Now I can bring back in my character render, or my player. Now for this, I'm gonna go ahead and make a nice little color correction to it. So camera raw filter, I'm gonna go into. So filter, camera raw filter, and then it goes into here. This little thing right here gives you the option to see a before and after. Click on this, zoom in for ourselves. Right, I'm gonna say for automatically, regardless of a really nice clean picture, but I'm gonna say sharpening, bring this up to like 20% or so, or anywhere around that. Go to basic though. The cool thing I do mostly is literally just taking the texture, bumping this all the way up to like 70, 80, you know, maybe like your photographers out there maybe hate me a little bit, but that's okay. Texture up there, clarity, make this around like 15 to 12 or so right here. Nice little simple ratio there. Now for the blacks, I'm gonna lower this a little bit. Whites, I'll lower this. I won't lower the blacks, excuse me. I'll up the shadows a little bit, up the highlights a little bit, just like so. So 5, 10 around, 15 around that, just a good ratio. Of course, it depends on what your picture is overall. Press okay. Now you'll see it makes it look super, super fun and very kind of like just matches the grunge style that we're kind of going for this header here. It looks really, really good, and I'm pretty satisfied with it. So with that being said, I'm actually going to go back into here and delete some of this stuff from the bottom, because I want it to kind of be seamless right around here. Yeah, look at that. Oh, okay, much better. Love that. Perfect. So now what we can do for ourselves is add in our name for a second. So we're gonna add in Nitro. Now for the record, all this stuff here is gonna make me really weird to actually type for the record. So I might even group this all together and just say, yo, rasterizes, or, you know, make it a smart object if you guys want to as well. Obviously, since we did that, none of these are gonna be behind it. That's whatever, it's fine. If you guys want to, you can layer mask it, take a brush at 100% opacity and then just erase them if you guys want to. It all depends on what you guys want to do, but I wouldn't really recommend that. This is fine. It's whatever. But just for the record, if you want to type, it's going to be super hard. So Nitro is the word I'm going to type in. That is his name, right? For the esports player. Make it pure white for us. And now the font that I'm going to be using is Termina, which is an Adobe font for the record. If you guys want to go ahead and download it, I highly recommend it. I'm going to use heavy, not too much. I think heavy is a pretty good ratio, just like so. We have Nitro, right? That is the name of the player. So I'll go ahead and just say above it, right above is a nice little subtext, which usually is, hey, I'm a professional player for X team, in this case, 100 Thieves, right? I'm gonna make this nice and small, just like so. Now for this, obviously you can use the same font if it has different weights. Just lower the weight down since it makes it less important. That way the hierarchy makes a lot of sense, right? Maybe like Demi, I think Demi is a pretty good amount, just like so. I'll make this a little more smaller. A little thing you could do as well is you can highlight the name of the team, change the color to red or whatever color team name is, right? That way it kind of stands out a little bit more, just like so, right? Same exact thing I did over here, but I didn't actually do the 100 Thieves highlighted, but that looks kind of cool, right? So you can also do for the information bar here is I'm gonna take this little logo that I had over here, right? Take it, say, yo, boom, plop it down right here. Now, of course, my little sidebar or this little bar here is actually a little bit smaller than my other one. I'll make it a little bit bigger. Right, move this up here, and you can put some other small information stuff. So for me, of course, the actual style of it is gonna be like 100 Thieves typed out, just like so. Then below it will be 100 Thieves spelt out. Right, you can kind of do the same exact thing if you guys wish to. I mean, at this point, everyone in the universe does it, so I'm not really worried about it. But we'll do just, you know, established at the time the place was, how do you say, the company was made. Then gaming, entertainment, and apparel, just like so. Right, I'll just do this little cross kind of idea pattern here, just like this. Make this a little more smaller. And this will be a little information stuff. So you can put your team name down here, maybe when they were established, maybe a little bit of description of who the team name was, and looks really, really good. Like a nice little very simple typography change and idea that just makes your header look really, really dope in my opinion. So now that we have all that good stuff, we're basically almost done, but right below the character here, the player here, we're gonna make a new layer. We're gonna take a red brush. So whatever red you guys use for your primary color that you guys are going for the team, just use that same exact thing. Of course, make your hardness 0%. And I'm gonna click one time behind him, just like so, or a few times actually, just so I get a nice little bright kind of like ratio here. I think I clicked around 3 times right there. And of course my brush is not right here, right? It's like a little bit further down in the middle for the record. And then I'll make a new layer. I'm gonna click again. Before I do that though, I'm gonna change it from linear, from normal to linear dodge add. And I'm gonna click. And this will give it a nice little simple, nice glow. That looks really good. I'm okay with that, right? Very simple glow stuff, right? And then I'm gonna go over here to the adjustments table and I'm gonna use solid color. Now this solid color, I'm gonna make it sure the same red, right? I'm gonna move it up a little bit, just like that. So it's of course lighter. Now I'm gonna go over here. It'll automatically have a layer mask. So what you can do is hold control and backspace or alt backspace, depending on which one the color fill is. Black fills in, white deletes. So just do control backspace. Alt backspace till it basically deletes, so it's not actually there anymore. Then right click, clip mask this layer to the actual player right here. Right now I'm gonna take my brush, a soft brush, and white will fill in. So if you use a white brush, you can see how it's filling in. I'm gonna also change my blend mode to, I think I'm gonna go with, which one should I go with? So I'm actually gonna go with pin light here. So I'm gonna go with pin light, and also for the record, the color that I chose is not light enough. So on pin light, or whatever colors can be basically fine, or even you can use like a red brush that's like the perfect, like, how do you say, like hue ratio or darkness ratio. For me, I'm gonna click above or here. So I'm gonna use pin light. So pin light's the one I'm gonna use. I'm also gonna recommend the fact that, of course, my color is a little bit too dark. So if you see, if I just take this color, move it all the way up to the top, move it toward the left a little bit, you can start seeing it feel a little more glowy. Now this shoulder here is not my favorite shoulder. I didn't, of course, delete it enough. So if you use X to switch between your black and red, you can see, or black and white over here, X is switching in between, between them. So of course, like I said before, black is filling in, or excuse me, erasing. White is actually filling in. So if I use a white brush now, I'll go ahead and just say, nice little soft brush, right? Zero hardness, click super far away, right? I'm not clicking in here, right? You wanna click away from the actual person, right? Just like this, very subtle clicks around. Same thing over here, very subtle clicks around. It'll give you a very, very nice glow. That's exactly what we're looking for. We can do the same thing on the face a little bit, right? Just like this, right? That looks pretty good there. Now, if you mess up and go too far on the shoulder, press X, change the black brush, go back in here, and then say, yo, fix this up a little bit, right? Now, of course, blend. I think Pinlight is my favorite one here, but there are going to be some things that look way better on this side of the shoulder on a different lighting. But I'm going to say Pinlight for now is pretty good. We look okay right there. I'm not opposed to this. It looks good. It looks fine for me. However, I could definitely go into this a lot more detail, but for the record, at least you guys understand the idea of having a nice little halo ring around it. So for me, I think the left looks really good. The right is not my favorite, but it's okay. If I did want to as well, I can just clip mask another new layer to it. Take a nice little brush, go around again, and then you linear dodge add it, kind of cheat the actual way to make it feel like it's glowing a little bit more. If you guys wish to do that same exact thing, you guys can. But for now, I'm gonna say it's pretty good. And I'm actually just gonna go ahead and now and add in that last little thing that we did, which is basically the same name, right? So I'm gonna take the word Nitro, take it below, maybe even the character render just like this, right? Alt drag it. I basically forgot about this for a second, but I'm making it nice and big, right? And this will basically be a nice little way of adding in some contrast, even below the actual, all the way below the bar, I think is a really good place to put it at, right? I'm gonna change this color to a nice gray, just a little simple middle gray, just like that, right? Now, once it's gray, I'm gonna click on it. Also, I didn't think I changed it for the record, nope. Make it gray, and I'll go over here and go to filter, noise, add noise, basically drag this. It's gonna ask you about smart object, you just make it a smart object, right? Make this super, super high. I would say right around, I don't know, like as high as it could go, maybe like 170, 150 is a pretty good ratio. Gaussian, I think, is okay, but uniform looks a lot better in my opinion, right? Once you guys have that, you can press Control U on your keyboard, bring up the hue and saturation table, take the lightness, just drag this farther down. That will give you a nice ratio. That is super nice right there. I love that. Press OK. Now I'm gonna make it a little more smaller and tighten it up a little more to the left-hand side. And right there, that adds a nice little simple, nice little contrast in there. Looks very fun. Now, the last thing guys you can do if you guys wish to, we wanna add a little brightness and contrast, you guys can, right? A little brightness, lower the contrast. Also, a little fun thing you can do as well is on a gradient map, a nice black and white, same thing, right? If you click on the actual thumbnail of this, right, go to where it says filter or select color range, right? And you want to click around, you can actually find some really cool things you can do. You can find some really fun, like red. Like if you had multiple colors as well, it'll look kind of like a little more better. But if you have just red, you can click around a few spots. You see if you can find like a really fun ratio that looks kind of fun and cool. But it doesn't really work here, but it's definitely something you guys want to like explore for sure. But I'm gonna press OK and say whatever for now. But regardless, this is basically the thing I'm gonna show you guys. This is basically it. Really quickly to show you guys to save it, Control Alt Shift S, or basically File Export Save for Web. I recommend you guys saving it in JPEG at 100% or 100% quality, and then upload it, and you're good to go. Don't change the size to like 150. Don't do this. Don't do like half the size or whatever. Just upload it to 3,000 by 1,000, and you should be good to go. But with that being said, that is the end of the video here today. So hope you guys did enjoy. Hopefully it was fun. Hope you guys can go into your own little Photoshop and explore some really fun ideas for your esports headers. Of course, I don't know how I have a playlist, but I do have a lot more esports header channel videos on my channel, or esports videos on my channel that you can definitely still check out. Just for the record. But yeah, that'll be it for me today. Of course, don't forget to download the assets, the fonts. Don't forget to like if you guys did. If you guys are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe. Follow me on TikTok. Follow me on Twitter, AssetsOHQ. Did I say that already? Don't know. But yo, I love you guys so very much. That is it for me. AssetsOHQ out. Don't forget to keep smiling, stay positive, and stay freaking productive, guys. I love you guys so very much. Enjoy your new like headers and all that good stuff. And that's it. I love you guys. Enjoy your weekend.